A Cessna plane that went missing in the Philippines' Bicol region on Saturday has been found. Kamalig Mayor Caloy Baldo says the debris of the plane was seen near the crater of Mayon volcano based on drone footage. But rescuers in the area were temporarily asked to go down since it's within the 6-kilometer permanent danger zone. Authorities also have yet to find any proof of life. The plane had four individuals on board, but it took off from the Bicol International Airport. It was scheduled to land in Manila, but lost communication with the control tower. Its last contact was at 3 minutes after takeoff. This is the second Cessna plane that went missing this year. The other aircraft that disappeared in Isabela Province almost a month ago has yet to be located.
Now, landslides and flash floods hit the Visayas and Mindanao regions over the weekend due to persistent rains caused by a low-pressure area. In southern Leyte, motorists were forced to use only one lane of the national highway following a landslide in Lungsod Daan village. At least 15 people fled their homes in the town of Tomas Opus. The right Taft Road in eastern Samar also closed to traffic due to a landslide. Meanwhile, flash floods hit the Caraga region, prompting evacuations among residents of Surigao del Norte, Surigao del Sur, Agusan del Norte, and Agusan del Sur. At least 10 villages in Butuan were also inundated, displacing several individuals.
Let's get an update on the low-pressure area being monitored by State Weather Bureau PAGASA. Joining us on the line, PAGASA weather forecaster Rhea Torres. Good morning, Rhea. What do you have for us?
Yes, good morning to you as well. As of the moment, the low-pressure area we were monitoring was last located at 195 kilometers north of Legazpi City, Albay, or 210 kilometers east of Infanta, Quezon. Said low-pressure area will be bringing cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over Bicol region, mainland Cagayan, Isabela, Aurora, Quezon, and northern Samar. Meanwhile, northeast monsoon will be continuing to prevail and affect areas of northern Luzon, therefore for the rest of Cagayan Valley, Cordillera Administrative Region, and Ilocos Norte, cloudy skies with rains will be expected. For the rest of the country, that includes Metro Manila, here in the rest of Luzon, northeast monsoon will be continuing to prevail. Generally, fair weather conditions or partly cloudy to cloudy skies will be experienced with chances of light rains. Meanwhile, for Visayas, Mindanao, and the rest of Mimaropa, partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain showers or thunderstorms due to localized thunderstorms will be expected. As of the state of our coast, as of the moment, we still have a gale warning raised over the seaboards of northern Luzon and eastern seaboards of central and southern Luzon. Therefore, for fisher folks and other small sea crafts, they are advised not to venture out into the sea while larger sea vessels are alerted against big waves. Temperatures in Metro Manila will be ranging from 23 to 30 degrees Celsius for Baguio City, 14 to 22, Legazpi City, 24 to 29, Metro Cebu, 24 to 30, and for Metro Davao, 24 to 31 degrees Celsius. And that is the latest here from PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center. This is Rhea Torres reporting.
Rhea, what do you think, what kind of weather do you think we are looking to see at least until the end of the week?
Yes, as of the moment here in Luzon, the northeast monsoon will be continuing to prevail, so generally fair weather conditions besides chances of light rains may be expected over large portions of Luzon. Meanwhile, for Visayas and Mindanao, isolated rain showers and thunderstorms will be expected until 24th of February. So by tomorrow, we're expecting improving weather conditions over a large portion of our country.
All right. Thanks for that update, Rhea. You stay safe.
A Filipino and her three children confirmed killed in the powerful earthquake in Turkey. The Philippine Embassy in Ankara says Emily Bayer and her three children, who were previously reported trapped under the rubble, were already laid to rest by her Turkish husband. They were among the more than 46,000 people killed in the 7.8 tremor that struck Turkey and Syria nearly 2 weeks ago. The Migrant Workers Department pledges assistance for Filipinos in Turkey who want to return here in the Philippines.
Those who wish to be repatriated will be repatriated safely home. Pagdating naman din dito, bibigyan pa rin sila ng assistance, reintegration assistance.
Turkey has ended most search and rescue operations as hopes of finding more survivors fade. Meanwhile, U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken visited Turkey and announced another $100 million worth of humanitarian aid.